Good evening, everybody, and a very warm welcome to the Dublin Hall here at the Royal Borough of Kensington and Chelsea.
Welcome to the gala finale concert of the London International Choral Festival. You're in for a great evening. But first of all, what I'd like to do is introduce you to somebody who has been pivotal and incredibly important in the creation of this event. Would you please put your hands together and give a very warm welcome to our patron, Roger Bramble.
First of all, a very, very happy New Year. My Lord Mayor, arm up, please, my Lord Mayor, your worships, and lucky music lovers. Now, there could be a reaction to that, but you've not heard a note yet, but I mean it. In my dotage, I have the great fortune to be able to spend much more of my time on music-related affairs. And they take me to glamorous places here and in other countries. Yet, this event is one to which I look forward possibly more than any other. The encounter of the cream of young voices from the United States with the cream of young orchestral players in this country creates what I describe as a musical nuclear fission. You may judge that in due course. We must say straight away that possibly the real heroes are the young singers, because not only they have to learn new music, but they have had to spend a lot of time raising the economic wind to come and delight us at the start of our year. Thank you. A short word about the repertoire. We tried to combine the best of British, and very clearly there is a very strong musical school which comes mainly from Hollywood, and you will hear some wonderful music from that end as well. They are tearjerkers, so ladies, I hope your mascara is in good form, frankly. But if you don't shed a tear, I shall be very, very cross. Right at the end, all of you will be required to join into the singing of Land of Hope and Glory. You have the words on our program, I think. Edward Elgar himself did not like them, and I must say they are rather bombastic. However, they reflect the zeitgeist, the spirit of the times, and I have absolutely no intention of apologizing for it. It would be it'd be insincere and totally incorrect. There is another, and this is my last shot, zeitgeist coming up, and it is an expression I abominate. But because it is appropriate, you're going to get it straight. Enjoy.
Thank you very much indeed, Roger Bramble. Now, as Roger said,
you all should have programs, so I'm not going to bore you by reading out what you're going to hear, because you're going to recognize it anyway. But what I would like to do is simply to introduce you to the six choirs from the United States of America that we have here, supported by our English LICF, London International Choral Festival Choir. And the groups from the United States of America are the Buford High School Chamber Chorus from Buford, Georgia, with Mr. Taylor Greer as choral director. The Devlin High School Tour Choir from Denver, Colorado, with Mr. William White, choir director. Forest Hill High School Dimension 20 Choir from West Palm Beach, Florida, with Mr. Sterling Frederick as their director. Licking Heights High School Choir from Pataskala, Ohio, in the USA, Meredith Smith. The Somerset College Preparatory Academy Invictus Choir from Port St. Lucie, Florida, with Eileen Wallentin. And last but most certainly not least, it's just alphabetical, you see, University High School Titan Chorus from Orange City, Florida, and Mr. Jonathan Anderson. Clearly it's not too bad being the last listed, therefore. Anyway, this lucky group of young singers is going to be accompanied this evening by the simply superb and magnificent Young Musician Symphony Orchestra, for whom this is your home, is it not now? Cadogan Hall, and they are led by Evie. Evie Rogers, sorry. And of course, conducted by the inimitable James Blair. Please give James a very warm welcome and let the concert begin.
Thank you. Thank you.
been probably the best we've ever had yet. So thank you very much, everybody. Well, we're nearing the end, and you're going to have your chance to participate in this last number.
Perhaps more than once, even. You never know. Anyway, the point here is that, of course, James wonderfully directs this superb orchestra, James Blair, that is. But these choirs are brought together just for this one week by the choral director of the London International Choral Festival, who I think has inspired you just a little bit, I hope anyway, Mr. James Henshaw. And so now, Maestro Blair, over to you, sir.